Good morning students, today we are going to solve some more numericals to obtain the state model of the system. Now consider the next problem, obtain the state model for the network shown below. Consider VR2 as the output. Where you have VR2, that is voltage across R2 is going to be considered as a output factor. Here how many energy storage elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to consider 4 state variables, that is x1, x2, x3, x4. If it is an inductor, current will be your state variable. If it is a capacitor, voltage is going to be your state variable. So first, x1 is equal to I1, that is current flowing through the inductor 1. x2 is equal to I2, that is current flowing through your inductor 2. Because as I have shown the loop here, the current flowing through the inductor 1, L1 is I1, and the current flowing through the inductor L2 is I2. Therefore, x1 is I1, x2 is I2. What is the voltage across? That is C1. When you consider the capacitor, so here voltage will be your state variable. So x3 is equal to VC1 and x4 is equal to VC2. As stated earlier, always write the state variables in terms of first order differential equation. So x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot, x4 dot. What is x1 dot? Di1 divided by dt, which is equal to diL1 divided by dt. What is x2 dot? Di2 by dt, which is nothing but diL2 divided by dt. What is your x3 dot? dVc1 divided by dt. x4 dot will be dVc2 by dt. Now we need to apply a loop equation for this. Here how many inputs we have? 2 inputs, 1 output. How, looking at the circuit only, you can say it has got 2 inputs, that is V1 and V2 are your input, and the output VR2 has to be considered. So U1 is equal to V1 of t, U2 is equal to V2 of t. We need to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. So Kirchhoff's voltage law, if you apply to loop 1, so to this loop if you apply a Kirchhoff's voltage law, V1 is equal to L1 into di1 by dt plus R1 into I1. The current flowing through this resistor is I1, and here also I2 is flowing, so both the currents are entering. So I can write it as I1 plus I2 into R2 plus VC2. So voltage V1 is equal to L1 di1 by dt plus R1 into I1 plus I1 plus I2. So why we are putting plus, you all know, into R2 plus VC2. So V1 is nothing but U1, L1, what is di1 by dt? di1 by dt is x1 dot. R1, what is your i1? x1. So replace all the physical quantity available in this equation with the state variable quantity. After replacing, you find out what is x1 dot. In a equation, suppose if you are converting any physical quantity to electrical quantity, a equation will have, that is, your state variable will have your, the other part of the equation will have, that is right hand side part of your equation will have only the terms in terms of your state variable and input variable. And in the same equation, you will not get two first order differential equation. For example, if you consider this equation, here you have only one x1 dot. You will not get x1 dot, and here you will not get x2 dot. So in one equation you will get only one first order differential equation. Therefore x1 dot is equal to, from this you can identify what is your x1 dot. Same way you apply Kirchhoff's K voltage law to this particular loop. So when you apply, you will get V2 is equal to L2 di2 by dt plus Vc. So here V2 is equal to L2 di2 by dt plus VC1. And what is the current flowing through this resistor R2? Here also the current is, both the currents are in the same direction. So if the current are in, if your loop assume direction is opposite, then you can put I2 minus I1 or I1 minus I2 depending upon the reference. Whereas here the loop assumed to be on the current flowing through the center point is going to be on the same direction. Therefore the current flowing through this R2 is going to be I1 plus I2. Therefore, V2 is equal to L2 di2 by dt plus VC1 plus i1 plus i2 into r2 plus vc2. Likewise, you need to write the equation. So once the equation is written, you have to convert all the physical quantity into electrical quantity. So after converting, you are getting one x2 dot term. So now you have identified what is your x1 dot and what is your x2 dot. Now you have to identify what is your x3 dot and x4 dot. How we can identify x3 dot and x4 dot? In a sense, here we have two capacitor, right? So you apply the KCL, that is current loop. Incoming current is equal to outgoing. What is the voltage across the capacitor? So VC1 is equal to 1 by C1 integration of I2 into dt, because the current flowing through C1 is only I2, whereas the current flowing through capacitor 2 is going to be I1 plus I2. So VC1 is equal to 1 by C1 integration of I2 into dt. Now to remove this integration, I have to differentiate this side. So I will get dVC1 divided by dt, which is equal to 1 by C1 I2 into dt. So what is dVC1 by dt? dVC1 by dt is nothing but x3 dot. So from this we can identify what is our x3 dot. Same thing, you identify what is the voltage across the capacitor VC2. So VC2 is equal to 1 by C2 integration I1 plus I2 into dt. As I explained earlier, why this capacitor is carrying two current, in the sense in the loop, both the currents are in the same direction. So we will get I1 plus I2 into dt. So dVC2 by dt is equal to 1 by C2 I1 plus 1 by C2 into I2. Replace all this physical quantity by means of your state variable quantity. Now we have identified what is our x1, what is our x2, what is our x3, what is our x4. In turn, we have identified the first order differential equation also, x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot and x4 dot. Now which is our output? Voltage across the resistor R2 is going to be our output. Therefore, the voltage across the resistor is written as VR2, which is equal to the current flowing through the resistor R2 is I1 plus I2 into R2. Now replacing this physical quantity by means of your state variable quantity, you will get this output equation. Now you can write your state equation and output equation. We know that state equation is x dot of t is equal to A x of t plus B u of t. And also you guys know how to frame. Also you know that how to frame your A matrix, B matrix. A matrix will be four state variables are there, so I'll get 4 cross 4. B matrix is 2 inputs, so 4 cross 2. And this particular row contains the coefficient of x1, x2, x3, x4 in x1 dot. And your second row contains the coefficient of x1, x2, x3 and x4 in x2 dot. Third row contains the coefficient of x1, x2, x3, x4 in x3 dot. Fourth row contains the coefficient of x1, x2, x3, x4 in x4 dot. Same way here. So this matrix has to be written from the equation framed like x4 dot, x3 dot, x2 dot and x1 dot. And output equation is, we have only one output. So one output means here 1 cross and A, B, C matrix will be 1 cross 4. And you have only x1 term and x2 term. The coefficients are R2 and R2. You have to write it a matrix like this. And also they have told like you can replace the resistance value with 1 ohm, 1 ohm. And inductance value with 1 Henry. And capacitance with 1 Farad. So if you replace it, you will get your state equation and output equation matrix. And follow with this, you people can draw the state model for the corresponding problem.